And the New Year celebration kicked off early with Kevin Miller from Copper Kitchen.
Good morning. That's right. Good morning. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, too. You are doing a rack of lamb.
Stay in with your sweetheart and cook dinner.
All right. That sounds like a great idea.
I don't like being on the roads on New Year's, although we do have to be because we have a lot of events that night. Mm-hmm. But this is simple. Rack of lamb is available everywhere now, and it is so beautiful. It's priced right. You know, this whole rack is about $10.
That's amazing.
Cut it in half, do a little hors d'oeuvre, and it feeds two people.
The lamb chop lollipops come from this, right?
Absolutely. Okay. This is a very simple recipe. The recipe is already on the website.
Okay, salt and pepper?
Salt and pepper. Kosher salt, cracked black pepper.
Both sides.
We're going to sear it in a pan.
Okay.
You just want to get it a little brown. Mm-hmm. It's still going to be rare.
Right.
But you want to get a little brown. It's not cooperating. Of course, I didn't heat it up too.
Oh, of course. But that's okay. We can give everyone the idea what to do because you have a lot of
absolutely,
steps with this,
absolutely.
But they're quick.
There's a finish tier. What I do is I have some of these amazing panko breadcrumbs. Mm-hmm. They're available everywhere now.
Sure.
It's a Japanese breadcrumb. It's very light and crispy. I use some sage, rosemary, and thyme. Those are all like the, what I consider the winter herbs. They're hardy herbs, and they're all fantastic with
Simon
lamb.
Simon and Garfunkel herbs.
Exactly. Salt and pepper again. A little olive oil. Just make a paste. Mustards. There are so many amazing mustards on the market now. This one I found, it's a black currant mustard.
This smells really good. It's got a strong scent
to it. It's amazing. We're going to pretend that's a little more brown. Right. You just want to get a little color, just to kind of start the process. We're going to rub it with this black currant mustard. You can use a whole grain mustard. You can use a Dijon.
And it looks like that. It looks like that berry type
it's
of look.
It's beautiful.
To it.
Okay. They have cranberry mustards, which would also work really well with this. Mm. Toss this. And we're just going to coat it with the breadcrumbs.
Like
you get that nice crunch with all the herbs.
Just on that one side?
Just on the one side, yeah. You can put some garlic in it if you want to. We're going to throw it in the oven. Hot oven, about 400 degrees for about 15 minutes.
That's it.
I like my lamb medium rare to medium.
Okay.
I don't like it on the rare side. Yeah, I like medium, medium well, maybe 20 minutes. Hot pan here. I have some butternut squash.
Oh, yeah.
Brussels sprouts. I love Brussels sprouts. Even my brother, who hates Brussels sprouts, tries them this way. Just get a little butter hot in the pan, brown butter. Get it real brown, get that nutty taste, a little salt and pepper again. The sauce recipe is also on your website. I just reduced a little bit of red wine vinegar, red wine, full body red wine, a little bit of the mustard,
Put
just
it
to
in
reinforce
there.
That mustard.
Right.
And then I reduced that to about a half a cup, whisk in some butter.
Some more butter.
My favorite ingredient.
It makes
I'm sorry.
It better. Butter makes it better.
And we're going to put that on the plate.
That looks delicious. And get the vegetables all nice and
yep,
soft.
Yep, we have this lamb here. We'll just cut it. Cocktail. This is a very simple champagne cocktail.
Okay.
You don't have to go expensive with champagne. This is actually a sparkling rosé. So it's a sparkling wine, essentially.
Sure. So you put some Grand Marnier.
A little bit of pomegranate juice. I've made this pear syrup, which again is on your website.
Okay.
It's a spiced pear syrup.
Looks thick.
It's a little thick. It's like nectar. And then just top it off with the bubbly, because that's what New Year's Eve's all about.
All right.
And look at the color. And if you want to get really naughty, Jennifer, a little bit of Grand Marnier on the top.
Oh, it smells so good. So festive for the new year. Oh, that looks awesome. How long do your veggies need to cook for?
Like about three, four
just
minutes.
To make them tender?
Yeah, they're still going to be nice bright green. Mm-hmm. But it's very simple.
All right, looks good, Kevin.
Dish.
Thank you so much, Kevin Miller,
Thank you.
Copper Kitchen,
Happy
making us celebrate right here. And the weather.
Yeah.